benefit of the viewers today. How does zakat help in maintaining the economy of a given society?
As far as the economy of society is concerned, unlike capitalism or socialism, the economic order of Islam is based on the principle that everything in this earth, everything in the universe belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the owner of everything in the universe. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, sustainer, cherisher, and the owner of everything that exists in this world and in the universe. Based on this principle, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 33, that give in charity out of the means which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wealth, and Allah has made us trustees. Allah is asking us to give out of the means that He has provided us. Allah repeats the message in Surah Hadith, chapter number 57, verse number 7, that give out of the sustenance which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you a heir of. What Allah has given you, the property, the sustenance, give out of that. So we as human beings are the trustees or vicegerent of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the reason we have to spend it and earn the wealth according to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since it belongs to Him. And there are various guidelines given in the Quran how the wealth should be earned and distributed and spent. As far as how the wealth should be earned, there are various prohibitions that you cannot earn this way, otherwise everything is halal. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 278 and 279, that give up the demands of riba. Riba is interest, it's usury. And those who give up not the demands of riba, usury and interest, take notice of a war from Allah and His Rasul. So earning through riba, through usury, through interest is haram. It is one of the biggest sins as far as earning is concerned. And Allah further says in the Quran that you cannot earn through bribing. Allah says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 188, that use not your wealth as a bait for judges in order you may eat other person's wealth. So using your money to bribe people so that you may earn more wealth is prohibited in Islam. Similarly, stealing and robbing is prohibited. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 38, as to the thief, be it a man or a woman, chop off his or her hand as a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So earning while robbing is prohibited. Furthermore, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 90, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O you believe, innamal khamru wal maisuru, most certainly intoxicants and gambling, wal ansabu wal azlamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rishtum minamali shaitan. These are Satan's handiwork. Fashtanibulalukum tuflihun. Abstain from this handiwork that you may prosper. So earning by means of intoxicants, gambling, making idols, or fortune telling, all these are prohibited in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further gives us guidance. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 33, that do not force your maids into prostitution, those who want to remain chaste, just in order to gain some wealth or goods. But if anyone forces them after this, then Allah is of forgiving and most merciful. But you cannot earn through prostitution. And furthermore, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 19, and those who love scandal to be published and broadcast amongst the believers, they will surely get a grievous penalty in this world and in the hereafter. That means anyone who likes to publicize or broadcast scandal amongst the believers, it is prohibited. And further, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 2, that give to the orphans their property once they become adult. Means if you're a guardian to the property of an orphan, give it to them when they mature. And do not exchange your goods which are useless, with their goods which are good. And neither do you mix up your goods with their goods. For all those who do this, they are doing a great sin. So there are various things mentioned in the Quran that you cannot earn by means of riba, interest, or by bribing, or by robbing, or alcohol, gambling, idol worship, fortune telling, by prostitution, by scandalous ways, or by eating the orphan's property. This is a guideline given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which you find in the other world today, in the modern world. All this is very common. And Allah also gives us a way, gives us guidelines how to spend the wealth. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 261, if anyone sows one grain in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give him 7 years, each year bearing 100 grains. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give you 700 times profit. In business terminology, Allah will give you 70,000% profit. In which business will you get 70,000% profit? And Allah continues and says that He will give you multiple times more. So the best way to spend is in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is charity. Allah further repeats the message in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 271. That if you disclose the charity that you give, it is well. But if you conceal it and make it reach those people who are needy, that is the best for you. It will cover up your sins. And Allah knows. Giving charity is good. Allah has given you permission to disclose it, also to tell it to others. But the best is disclosing. Allah says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 277. As to those who believe and do righteous deeds and establish prayers and they give charity, that is zakat, they will receive the reward from their Lord. And on them shall be no fear and they shall not have any penalty. Allah says in Surah Dhariyat, chapter 51, verse number 9, Allah says, and give charity to those who ask and even to those who are prevented from asking. And if you know the person deserves, if he's needy, if he's poor, whether he asks or does not ask, yet give him charity. I'd like to mention one more verse. Allah says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 36, that serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and join not gods with him. And be good to your parents and the kinsfolks and the relatives and to the orphan, those who are in need, and to the neighbors, those who are near you, and to the neighbors, those who are strangers, as well as to the wayfarer and to what your right hand possesses. So Allah gives the categories of people who should be good to. And Allah gives a warning in the Quran, in Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9. Verse number 34 and 35, that as to those who hoard gold and silver and spend it not in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, announce to them a grievous penalty. And in the year after, the wealth which they hoarded will be taken and it will be heated in the fire of hellfire. The gold that they hoarded will be heated in the hellfire. And with it, they'll be branded on the forehead, on the flanks, and on the back. And it will be told to them that taste the wealth you hoarded. That's the reason zakat has been prescribed for the Muslims. And Allah says in Surah Al-Hashr, chapter 59, verse number 7, that it prevents the wealth from circulating amongst the rich. If every rich human being in the world gives zakat, poverty will be eradicated from this world. There will not be a single human being who will die of hunger.